We're in a very impressive landscape next to one of these old lignite mines. And what we found here was the oldest spears in the world. They are 300,000 years old. We find bones of animals. We find leaves. We find the smallest things you can imagine. I'm Ivo Vrijen. I'm an archaeologist and researcher, and I work here in Germany in the Forschungsmuseum Schöningen. So you can walk from the museum to the excavation site and see actual people working. They're not actors, they just have their working space there. What they're doing is by hand, they're excavating cubic meter after cubic meter of dirt, and sometimes they find nothing for a long time, and then all of a sudden they found a complete skeleton. In total, we have about 30,000 finds in our find database, and it's easier to have some 3D scans of the most important things, so you can always have access to them and you don't have to look them up in the collection.
My name is Giorgi Serangeli. I am the director from the excavation here in Schöningen. Schöningen is so important because it's the only site on the world with such a preservation. With this fantastic preservation, this is a window to the past. We can look and understand how was the climate and the environment and the life of the humans 300,000 years ago. For me, the scan is a possibility to give to the people in the hand one of these spears. It's fantastic, and it is look absolutely identical as the original, but the most important for me, it's not the original.
And of course, 3D imaging is one of the most important things you can have, because then you can have a virtual tour. So that's something we also worked on here in the museum. And it would be nice if people from all over the world have an impression of what we have here and then can decide if they want to come to Schöningen or not. And of course they will. We're also looking on the surfaces of bones, what has happened to these bones. So for example, what we can see is if humans were there when an animal died and they cut off some meat, their knives that were made out of stone, they would leave markings on the bones. So we'd find cut marks on the bones that are sometimes very difficult to see by the naked eye. But if you have very high resolution scans of the surface, you can make it easily to spot them, but also to share these with other people around the world. And I like it very much with this software that you can directly see in the computer what's going on, where the flaws are, where you can make your model a bit better. And just the workflow is much faster, but also the surfaces are documented much more in detail. Archaeology is not about finding the nicest thing and keeping it for yourself, it's about sharing it. And with 3D technology, we can share it with people all over the world.